Hello everyone. Today I have Thomas from Thomas de Monaco with me. Old friend, I would say. I mean, it feels like forever, right?
Yeah. But
it was 1 year ago we met at in a very cozy cafeteria here, and you know, you're still new or a fairly new brand.
Still new.
Right? Yeah, still new. And then I tried the fragrances, and I'm really glad. Thank you, Thomas, that we are finally sitting and talking.
Thank you.
Yeah, my pleasure. No, my pleasure. You know, I love what you're doing, and I see the evolution even in 1 year, how the brand has evolved, how the fragrances have evolved. So it's really my pleasure to be introducing it to my audience.
Perfect.
Thomas, please let us know a little bit about your background, because I think you have a very interesting background that you don't really show. You have started showing now, the more artistic, but I'll let you take it away.
Okay, it changed a lot meanwhile. I'm a photographer and a creative director working for all these big brands in Paris since a long time, and out of the nowhere, because it came that I produced these perfumes, started producing these perfumes. I was shooting a lot of these perfumes for the big brands, as I mentioned.
But so you're shooting photographs?
Photographs and filming. And so I made a present actually one day for my friends in Paris, and it was a perfume in a very, very limited edition. And then they told me, because they kind of an excitement was happening there, and let's go on, and so everything started actually, and so it changed in December, I think 20 it was, when I launched the first one. So it changed a little bit from the photography side now to the perfume side, from the visual side to the olfactive side.
Yeah,
so that's my little story.
Yeah, but so your real name is Thomas de Monaco?
That's my name, actually.
And then you also named it the brand.
Yeah, it's like my baby. It's my, when I do something, I stand with everything behind it. And so this is why I choose my name to be on the product.
Actually. Right, that definitely. So you are the face of the brand. You are, like, so to say, the founder of it. Yeah, the idea came out of you, and you use or you work with other noses to create the fragrances.
Yes, everything started actually with Frederick Dahlmann, with the first one, with Raw Gold, which is sold out and we don't see anymore here on the table.
Yeah,
because the bottles have gone.
Yeah, you know, it's one of the most iconic fragrances in my opinion. I've written a lot about it on Instagram. I read about it. I think you did a great job, not only in naming it, but also how the fragrance was created. It really felt, it was, you know, kind of touching all the touch points. So it was completely thought through from the beginning until the end, is what I'm trying to say.
Yes, that's a very interesting thing. So when it came out, and it was discussed a lot actually in social media, there was also kind of a growing hype behind this product. And it was very interesting that 50% actually at the end, when we look back to this time, was totally pro of this scent, and there is a big critic mess actually. But it was very interesting to follow these discussions because it's really a new statement in perfume.
Yeah, sure. I mean, polarizing. I mean, to be honest, I find the opening challenging.
Yes,
it's definitely very challenging. Like, I struggled with it, 10 minutes, you know, because of that strong honey, leather. It's challenging. I mean, there's no, but some people love it as well. But for me, after 10 minutes, what comes on the skin, it's like you say, it's raw liquid gold. That's liquid the feeling gold. On the skin can I have.
Yes.
Yeah.
But it's gone.
Yeah, but it's gone. And then there is a new version of it. So as you can see, we had, this is the old one. If you know the brand, they are quite iconic. This is how, you know, Thomas de Monaco is for me, the bottles that you see here. But you have now the newer bottles. Talk a little bit about what was here, maybe why you changed the bottle.
Yeah, there are different ways why I've changed the bottle. Actually, why I've chose the bottle in the beginning was because of Raw Gold. Because Raw Gold was a travel back to my adolescence, my youth in the 70s. So we wrapped everything, all the memories I had from this time in one perfume, actually, with Frederick Dahlmann. And I wanted to find a shape of a bottle which reflects a little bit of the 70s. And yeah. So this came out, that's why I've chosen the one with the gold cap, with mm-hmm. his soft shoulders and soft shape in general. So there is a nice 70s feeling in it. When you start doing a perfume, you have to rely on stock. You can start with your own bottles if you have enough power behind. Mm-hmm. But if you go like me, then you have to get a few bottles. And so in my case, I took a few more because I already was thinking there could be more actually in the product. And so there was enough space to produce another one, which is Ocœur and Grandbeau, the two ones. And I put them as a limited edition also in these bottles, actually. Of course, I wanted to continue after that with these bottles, but they are not existing anymore. Yeah. I mean, they are existing, but you have to take quantities and you have to wait forever for these production lines.
Mm-hmm.
So... this is actually a technical reason why I had to change the product.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And now you have the new fragrances mm-hmm. and the new packaging. So talk a little bit about the three that you have upcoming, like earlier this month.
October 18.
October 18. October 18.
Yeah. We are going out. It will be in Paris.
Yeah.
During the Rive de la Beauté. So you're invited to join us in the evening at 6 o'clock in Paris. There is a lot more going on in the city during these 3 days. Rive de la Beauté. We start also in Paris. We decided to launch it in Paris because mm-hmm. it's the start of my representation in Paris and okay. in France in general.
Yeah.
So it's a very nice event actually there.
Yeah.
The product, three products. I mean that's a must again for me. What we have done. So now when I look at the full line, which is actually, I think, 6 products now I have in total. I'm just looking if I found the first. I think I have one with me. Wait a second. Just that people know what was wrong. Yeah. Gold, actually.
Yes, that's amazing.
So
the French scent that started everything.
Yes, that's right? It. And now you see actually the line,
the pyramid,
the development of everything.
Yeah,
which is a nice pyramid going on here. And if I go from the raw gold, I never wanted to. I was not thinking to continue actually the perfume from the beginning, and it was always in my mind that I have really limited edition on the products, and I keep on that, that it's really limited. What's in mm-hmm. that bottle is not existing anymore.
Yeah.
With the rework of raw gold, I went in a more modern direction actually. Yeah. The first ones are very visual. Mm-hmm. Like raw gold, when I talk about the 70s, then I was always telling a lot of things about the visuality during that time.
Yeah.
With the new one, I wanted to make it a little bit more contemporary.
Okay.
Not a little bit, it's actually a contemporary and beautiful scent. It came out. It has the same DNA like the original one. We changed a few things in the scent to make it a little bit more stable.
Yeah.
Have it in a line which is not limited anymore.
Sure, but also it does not have the sharp edges that the original one had. So to be honest, what the original raw gold becomes, this is the new one is for me from the beginning, if it makes sense somehow.
Yes.
You know, it's just much easier and approachable without losing the unique raw gold, the honey, hay, leather kind of the DNA.
Yeah, that's this gourmand feeling is still there. We cut a little bit on the edges. We took out the civet, replaced it with a beautiful oud. Mm-hmm. We took off the oris, which was a very strong oris actually, and we took a very nice one over there. And we changed actually the whole sweet accord, which was in the beginning, this cognac element, this plum feeling, and we changed it completely with tabac oil, which gives us this nice sweetness in the whole scent.
Can you smell a raw gold together?
Yes, the new one.
The new one, because that's what everyone can try soon.
The reactions and are very good. I place it here.
Mm-hmm.
So this is for you.
Yeah. Yeah, it does have the same DNA, right?
As
but it's not so loud, and
yeah.
I mean, it is still full of life, so to say, but that was a grand, you know, a grand fragrance, so to say.
Yeah, the first one was very, not gendering, but
yeah,
it's a really masculine one.
Yeah.
It's for women, it's really hard to wear. You need to have a lot of power in your body to go with that. And with the new one, I wanted really to make a gender neutral perfume so that you can go in the evening, which is very sensual. When you enter a room, you have an ambience with you. And so that was actually the idea, so
mm-hmm.
that you get a beautiful presence with this new scent.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, of course, I only smell it here. I have to put it on the skin to see, because I know raw gold very well. But once they are out, it would be interesting to see how that develops on the skin, let's say half an hour in. Than the raw gold, but really, really beautiful, I think.
Yeah, the DNA actually is that we go, I'm very radiant. That's one of the main things of the brand, and it's long-lasting.
Yeah.
It's really long-lasting, and the idea that it's lasting over 6 hours, actually.
No,
that's
yeah, but I mean, Gunbeer and Occur, they are monsters.
They are monsters.
Also, I mean, they're all monsters in a way, but not intrusive. You know,
yeah.
They would stay on your skin. You would still get wafts of it, but nothing that bothers you.
And doesn't bother others also.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's very wearable fragrances, actually.
Yeah,
everything. So this is the raw gold.
Yeah,
I call it a rework. Actually,
yeah.
It's not a new edition
reformulation
or something
like this.
It's really a rework,
yeah.
Because we have really analyzed the old one, the first one, what we want to change, and we went completely and built it up a new one. So it's also it's not kind of that visual, so I leave it up to the people what they see, so
mm-hmm.
that they can build their own image, their own idea of this perfume. Yeah,
absolutely. And now, so this was raw gold, and then there are two new ones. That so what are the story, how did you come up with the ideas?
I wanted to have actually a line of a beautiful line of a few perfumes,
mm-hmm.
Which are my signature.
Yeah.
I'm building at the moment my signature with these new perfumes.
Mm-hmm.
So the idea that there will be six at the end.
Six at the end.
Six at the end. Each follows a very nice direction, which is maybe kind of these positive emotions.
Mm-hmm.
I want to follow with each of the scents. So one is more for this sensuality, which is a nice feeling on the skin. The other one is more for the freedom. The other one is more for happiness, and so on. So
mm-hmm.
this will continue. And with the other two ones, which I was launching, or I am launching at the moment, is the Sol Salgado,
mm-hmm.
Which means salty sun.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a word creation in a way. And we have the Fuego Futuro,
mm-hmm.
which is a complete other direction, actually, we're going. So the idea is not to have a sleek line with variations. Each perfume has its own character and is part of the whole brand.
The signature,
actually, the signature.
Definitely.
And when we start with this one first here, because this was the first, after the rebirth of Raw Gold, we came up with the Sol Salgado.
Yeah.
Sol Salgado. Start here. Yeah, we change. Ooh la la.
Yeah, it's really, really beautiful. I told you that this has been my favorite from the new one.
Yes, this is
really
so beautiful.
Takes me to Italy, to a coast, right away.
You can go wherever you want.
Yeah, wherever. It's just freedom is what I get from it.
Yeah, it's a nice, beautiful. It's a, if you think about a beautiful warm day, think about going into the evening when the sun is going down, the night is coming up, the warm winds are changing, the day flowers are going, the night flowers are coming up. And so this is actually this moment I really love. And Maros is my perfumer. We are working very close together with the company Luzzi. So
mm-hmm.
they have great products, actually, raw materials. He came up with the idea of the yellow flower linden blossom.
Yeah.
And so linden has such a healing
mm-hmm.
feeling in general. But and you mix it up with these salty elements, these ocean elements, but it's not both.
It's not aquatic.
No,
it's not. It's salty, but it's not aquatic.
That's it.
Yeah, it does not have that animalic, aquatic feel that you get on a seaside or on a.
No, not pipe. At all. So it's. I didn't want it to have it visually on the seaside, so it can be everywhere. In the continent, where the linden blossom, the mimosa is, of course, this is more a southern thing. What's in there is also a very nice smoked vanilla, which is not that sweet. So it's a very dry and salty one, which is playing there.
Yeah, I always, sometimes, you know, for me, a lot of people think in shapes. A lot of times think of fragrances in color, and this is yellow.
This is as yellow
a fragrance can be. We talked about it yesterday when you go on a beach and the sun comes up and you know you close your eyes and the sun goes in on your face.
That's
the feeling. You have the wind, you have the salt in the wind.
Yes.
Some florals. It's very photorealistic in that way.
Yes. And I like what I actually like, and I think, I don't remember who told me that, but it's kind of a golden spot all my fragrances have now. This is, I was calling actually a sweet spot, which makes it beautiful.
The golden spot,
so we took it up. And this will remain actually as a piece of the brand, this golden spot. And like the Davana oil, in this one here, the linden blossom has the same volume of this nice, in a way, sweetness in it.
Yeah, but there is also some mineral-like aspect, don't you think? Like some metallic mineral, people have, different opinions on it. I feel it's all the same. Anything that is, not synthetic is the wrong word, but mineral-like, maybe that air, almost like an airy aspect.
That's it, yeah.
Yeah.
So this gives also a lot of room, So it's beautiful. So.
And unique.
Many people have now had their nose on it, and I mean, it's always the same. People just start smiling when they smell it, and I never have expected these reactions actually.
Yeah.
And it's not female, not male, so everybody is just blown away with this scent.
Yeah, I mean, even though when it starts, you feel like it's feminine, but like. Five seconds in, it
changes.
You know, maybe the mimosas and all the yellow flowers, to say, almost like a ylang-ylang feeling that you get. But it's really as unisex as it can get.
Super,
really, really.
I'm very happy you love it.
No, I mean, you remember you first put it on? When was it? Like a long time ago, in the beginning.
Yes.
It was in Milan. We met in Milan at the hotel, and it was. I called it a happy scent.
Yes, that's
it's like a holiday happy scent.
That's it.
You know?
Yes.
And,
It's actually the magic hour, which lasts. The magic hour is this hour between sunset and the night. So before 6 o'clock in the evening, after six.
So that orange sky.
That orange sky. That blue hour. Many people call it also. And I wanted to have that. Little moment for the whole day,
but wherever you wanted, you had that moment. All right, amazing. And now the third and the last one,
Fuego Futuro, which is Spanish, which means the fire of the future.
Okay,
so this is why that name, from where does it come? So we started with that. That's a complete different way, actually. We went on the perfume. We started totally in the East. We went to Japan. We're trying what is happening there. Why are people in the south of Japan so happy? All these things. And we found there is a nice one which we could use. It's the mate tea, Absolute, which is the base, actually, from of the perfume. We went a little bit further in Japan, but couldn't find the right direction with this scent, so we started actually traveling with that one.
Okay.
And we started traveling from the east more to the west, and we went down more to the south, to the Maurus came up with the pepper timut, with the timut pepper, which is a very beautiful living pepper piece.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we should smell it. Huh?
Ah yeah, the opening, just
That's great. Yeah.
Yeah. So you were talking about pepper.
Yeah, that's you feel it. Freshness, this timut pepper, this colorful pepper actually, and so yeah, that was the second one actually. And then we thought, why not travel all over the East? And so we arrived somewhere in the high fields of Mongolia.
Yeah.
And then suddenly something came up in our mind, because there is a lot of history. We have, everybody has in his culture this mm-hmm. volume of where he comes from, what is the story of the family, what is the story of yeah. you. And so we decided that we build up with these elements kind of the heart of the everything, but then we tried to find the spirit, mm-hmm. The kind of future spirit that where do we go with all this volume what we have in our hearts, that we can open that and give to others also, mm-hmm. and find also new things for ourselves. So this is the traveling part actually of everything. And so we came up with Hay Absolute,
yeah.
which is the bison grass there. And we used a lot of pure Hay Absolute actually. The beautiful thing there is, if when the sun goes up and you have these leftovers of smoke from the early morning fires, you see the smoke, you have this incense feeling of everything in the air.
But it's more smoke than incense, would you agree?
Yeah.
It's not the church incense, it's rather the fire is gone.
Yes.
The leftover.
The
smoke.
Leftover. You can the leftover smoke. You can
correct.
Talk about also ash.
Ash. Correct.
Ash. Yes. It's ash, which is there, which gives this beautiful dryness in mm-hmm. a way. And so the story went on with this perfume.
Yeah.
We traveled a lot. We took some woods in there. Sandalwood is a very nice one there. There's a cedar wood in there from Alaska, actually. Mm-hmm. Marius was choosing. And we traveled on. And the story is very nice of this perfume. So we
yeah.
traveled. And somehow we arrived on a point and we thought, nah, that's maybe we went too far,
yeah.
actually with everything. And we went back in the production process about 3 months.
Yeah.
And we have no problem, the wind in here and
yeah.
the heat. And so we traveled back to three months, which is very a long way in development
creation,
of a perfume. Yeah.
Yeah.
So
mm-hmm.
these are many versions. We went back and we found that one, that moment where we thought that's a very nice one.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been thinking, oh my God, is this okay when we go back and say in a traveling process, go back and say that's the moment we should take?
Yeah.
Is this a perfume which has an end, which is a developed perfume to the
yeah.
end? And we've been thinking, no, we leave it like that, because we started from the beginning a travel. And so it's the traveler, a nomad,
yeah.
I call it, never arrives in a way.
Right, it just goes on.
Goes on. And so that's the idea of this perfume now. And it's not actually, and you feel it, it's not a perfume. It's more an ambience which you are
yeah.
creating if you're taking this. So it's an aura which you are carrying with you
yeah.
with this perfume.
Yeah.
So it's very healing, very spiritual. And
but I think, I understand both of them.
Mm-hmm.
This is the one I want to spend more time with.
You
know?
Have to?
Because it's not so easy to understand. It's simple,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's very minimalistic,
yes.
very, you know, but I feel, first of all, it doesn't do justice. Like most of the fragrances don't do justice on the blotter. I would love to smell it on the skin, but it's very minimalistic, like you mentioned, you know,
yeah.
and well-rounded, but this is something I need more time to understand.
That's it.
You know?
And I think with this one, I'm going a little bit back into the niche. In the extreme niche, I've been in the beginning with the raw
yeah.
gold.
Is
so there is a lot of people can talk about, find a position with this one. This is very interesting. And I'm waiting for the discussion, actually,
yeah.
On this perfume.
Yeah.
And what I see now, it's, and you get that feeling too, I think that every scent here has a different approach.
Yeah.
And this will be also the future, actually, because I'm planning to go on with the perfumes.
Yeah.
I cannot say at the moment what will happening. We are working on something beautiful, but we are not on the point at the moment to communicate that.
Yeah.
It will be for sure next March.
Next March.
Coming out with that.
Yeah, so 18th of October, these are releasing, Invited in Paris. And then next March and maybe next month, there would be something interesting.
You get something new.
That's amazing.
Yeah, I already booked there a suite, you're invited.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's always great, you know, like I mentioned, to see how the brand has evolved, Thomas. You know, and I'm really happy that we got the possibility to try the fragrances. Thomas, we don't have a discovery set here. Actually, there is a very interesting discovery set that I will put on the screen. And then you can see what we haven't talked about, which we will in the next coming videos, is the excellent job Thomas has done in the design. It almost, it feels like it's all six senses involved, including touch, which in perfume is not so common.
Yes.
That you can also sense, you know, have a sensory kind of also touch with all the packaging he has done. I will put again on the screen all the little small details that normal eye misses, an artist, a photographer's eye doesn't, that you would definitely see on the screen. Thomas, thank you very much for doing this.
Thank you for your time.
It's really my pleasure.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.